Alrighty, welcome back to the Polar Lights 1/350 scale Enterprise. Nice short video it's on. Well, we'll figure it out later. I think it's number 9. Anyway, I've got a lot of my paint work done. I'm going to break this video up into about 3 different days of work, or probably close to a week of work, a week's worth of work here that you'll see in just a couple of seconds. By the time this video is over, this thing will all be ready for decal and probably have a couple of decals on. You see, I've got my warp cells done. I've got my saucer section done with the first coat, with the first base coat of paint, ready to go back and remask and do my trim colors. The pearl coat, I went ahead and went this route. I don't know if I mentioned it in another video or not, but I tried it on a test piece, and I like the way it looks. It doesn't give me any sparkles, doesn't give me metallic flakes. You just don't see them. It just gives you a nice shimmering look, which is what the screen correct model has. So we did it to it, and liking the way it's turning out. I also didn't use my spray gun like I thought I would. I went ahead and just shot this straight out of the can because the can atomized it very well. But I did use an expensive primer. This stuff's about $10 a can, and you'll use about at least 2 cans, probably 3 cans of primer on this thing, because once you do your black coat on the outside to finish making sure your light blocking is complete, then you'll put your primer sealer on here. That A, it lightens it up a little bit, so you don't have to use so much of this, and B, it does give you a little guide coat so you can see any discrepancies. You can see I've got a couple of discrepancies right there I need to take care of. But other than, I mean, really it turned out well. All my panel lines turned out nice and crisp, even the ones I had to rescribe, especially these right here that I refilled and sanded. Notice I went ahead and just redid all this over again to make sure that I didn't have any loose ends. My fantail blended in really well. But I didn't put the panel line across here. Just figured it's too much work, and I'll probably slip with the scriber before I got that perfectly straight. There's a nice little curve area to do there, and that's just too much for me to try to handle. And I knew you would at least slip once, so I figured just blend it in, and bring the panel line to an edge right there. Looks nice. The one on the bottom, I had to rescribe all that. Build it up and just sand it down and put me a nice little line there. So all in all, it turned out well. Been a few days for me. It's been a half a second for you. So here we are. Got the engineering or the main hull painted with my white and pearl. Already got started with the masking of the color blocking. You see my engine or my main saucer. I've got it started too. And actually, I've got some done on my warp cells. You can see I've done the black on them. You're actually supposed to. If you're a stickler for realism, you're supposed to have these things kind of a dark metallic sheen to them. I'm not going to go that route. What I'll probably do is after I get the final coat, I'll probably go back and burnish the raised sections, give it kind of a glossy look, so that'll give the illusion of a metallic sheen. We'll go ahead and start with the color blocking on those in a few hours. Here's the thing with this color scheme. Depending on which movie you watch, which source you use, you'll have anywhere from a robin's egg blue or a duck egg blue to a gray color, even green. So if you take a look at the box art, they're pretty much on the blue side, really on the blue side, way too blue for my taste, not nowhere near like that in the screen correct version, or at least the way it appears on the screen. However, the decals are on a kind of a bluish color, so or the strong back decals are a bluish color. So what I'm going to do is compromise. I'm going to tone the colors that I say to use. I'm going to tone them down and mute them quite a bit. Probably go on the gray side, more of the blue. My vents that are supposed to be up here in these little sections, I don't know if they're vents or not, but they look like vents. These sections down here, they're supposed to be that duck egg blue, as well as this area right here. This area right here is supposed to be a dark duck egg blue, as well as up here. So what I'm going to do is kind of reverse everything. I'm going to completely eliminate the dark duck egg blue because it's too much contrast for the ship. And I'll paint my areas that are supposed to be the light duck egg blue. I'll paint them kind of a grayish color. This airs a little bit on the blue side. Airs a little bit on the blue side close to the decal version. The areas that are supposed to be the dark vivid color, I'm going to just mute them quite a bit and leave them blue, and that way that'll tie in with my decals and not give me so much contrast with them and still kind of keep a screen correct look, which is a really muted color. In fact, I had to go back and watch the movie or YouTube the movie and just watch some sections of it, just to even notice there was a color on the ship. I didn't even realize there was blue on there or gray on there. It was just so, it's so subtle that you don't see it. So it's definitely going to be more in your face than the screen version, but you know, we have to take what you get. So alrighty, it's been a couple of seconds, but it's been a couple of days for me, and done with the painting. Got just a little bit of touch-up work to do with the paintbrush, but all my airbrush work and all my masking work's done. You can see I've got my nacelles done. Everything's ready to go. Still got some touch-up work to do in here with the paintbrush to do my black sections with, but that little section right there was really tough to mask off and keep the bleeding down. I definitely would recommend you use some this right here, micro mask, and brush it on in this area right here, and use some really good masking tape. Don't use just the paper masking tape. Go to the body shop and get something like this right here. The thin one's paper. This one right here is like a really thin electrical tape, and it goes really good around tight bends and curves, stretches really good. Either one of those would work. Let's see here. I'll show you the bridge real quick. All turned out really nice. All my little areas right here, these were all masked off and sprayed. I'm not really sure what they are. I know these are phaser banks, but I'm not sure what these little gray squares are. But I know they were supposed to be gray. Everything's turned out really nice, though. Here's a decal sheet so you can see kind of how the blue matches. These are really nice decals, by the way. I've already put a couple of them on. In fact, that will bring me to the bottom section. I've started with my Aztec ink. This pearl paint, I wasn't sure about how it was going to accept decals, whether I need to put a coat of gloss on it or not, but because you see it's not really glossy, just kind of semi-glossy. But the decals go really well in there. And I put about four strips on. I'm trying to get the light on here. You can see how nice they dried. Just conformed right to that surface, so there's no need to go back with the gloss coat. I would recommend that you do the bottom first, because there is kind of a learning. Well, it's been so long since I've done decals, maybe this is the new norm, but these decals were kind of weird. They were very very thin, very brittle, easy to tear, hard to position. But on the plus side, they conformed really nice, hardly any air bubbles. They fit. The fit and finish was just phenomenal for a decal. And so, you know, really, I'm pretty pleased with them. I went ahead and did one of the sensor grids there just to see what that looked like, see how they were on a made up. Also, when you do the decals, the reason I say to do the bottom is there is a little bit of a learning curve to see how they position on here. Once you do the first one, you'll understand it. It does overhang here a little bit, but they're the same size as these molded in panel lines. So each one just goes to the panel line right here where this Aztec ink ends and the long horizontal strokes begin. That's your edge right there. So there's really no need to get all upset about trying to get these things fit in place right. They pretty much match themselves in place. And now you'll have some overhang up here because you were supposed to put the decals on before this dish. And tell me that until I got to the decal section, but you really need to put the dish on anyway to keep the light leaks down. I guess they're assuming you don't put lights in the model when you're doing it that way, but in this instance, you can see right here I've got probably, I don't know if you can catch it in the light or not, got a little bit of a flash to trim off while I'm waiting for them to dry. But really, they did really well. Also, I don't know if you can tell it or not, but they're multicolored decals, and the pearl finish shows through them really nicely too. It's almost like it's all one solid color, and it's almost like you took the time to mask off and spray these multiple coats on, but you don't have any masking lines, any raised areas. And you can see there's, I don't know if you can see it in the camera, there's beige buff sections, and there's kind of a blue, really, really faint colors, but they're discernible to the eye. They may not be in the camera. And the pearlescent comes right through on them, so it's definitely going to look really nice. I mean, I'm really pleased with them. Once you put the semi-gloss coat on there, they're going to look phenomenal. They really are. And let's just hope I don't screw them up. But anyway, I'll spend the next couple of days decaling, or maybe weeks decaling, and we'll have another update for you. It's coming right along.